This question is in reference to last Saturday's message as to when Jesus went to Tyre and Sidon. The question is like this: can you explain why this woman who came to Jesus for the healing of her daughter, we have Jesus first refusing and telling her that he was not sent except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel? And he added, "It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs." However, he then heals her daughter. Can we explain why Yeshua said these things?
You know, this passage has disturbed many, but there is a beautiful truth in there, especially when we consider the woman's faith and the disciples' lack of faith. The whole scene was a lesson of evangelism to the disciples who were soon to go to the Gentiles because the church was about to be formed right after. Right. So let us briefly look at the text. In Matthew 15, where there's a Gentile woman who comes to Yeshua and asks him to cure her daughter who was severely demon-possessed. So see the opening verses, verses 21, 22. It says, Jesus went away from there and withdrew into the districts of Tyre and Sidon. And a Canaanite woman from that region came out and began to cry out, saying, "Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is cruelly demon-possessed." You know, the first thing that we see is that she's a Canaanite woman from the Gentile region of Tyre and Sidon who comes to Jesus for her daughter. And what is amazing is that she recognizes Jesus as the Son of David, that is the Messiah of Israel. How could a Canaanite know so much about Yeshua when the religious leaders in Jerusalem did not? The Spirit of God was, of course, at work in many hearts of many Gentiles and Jews. But see what happens next, verse 23. But he, Jesus, answered her not a word. And his disciples came and urged them, saying, "Send her away, for she cries out after us." The disciples, who were taught from their youth not to mingle with Gentiles, not to eat with them, or even enter their house, did not realize this woman's faith, but were annoyed by her presence and her persistence. But Yeshua kept silent because he was to take this situation and use it as a lesson for his disciples. This was a crucial lesson for them. How could they assume responsibility over the ministry once Yeshua would have handed them over the helm of the church? Now, how could they go all over the world to preach the gospel with this type of biased view? At this point, one would have expected Jesus to rectify the situation, but just not yet. What he does is also baffling. But there's a reason behind it. He first turns to the woman and says in verse 24, "I was not sent except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." That was theoretically true, but practically we know that Yeshua went out of his way to help anyone, everyone, and Gentiles as well. Just like he did with the centurion in Matthew 8, where he was ready to enter his house, knowing very well that Jews would not do that. Furthermore, he seems to support the disciples' argument by adding something that sounds actually offensive. He says, "It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the little dogs." The children are the sheep of Israel. The dogs are the others. In the Hebrew scriptures and the New Testament, they have nothing good to say about dogs. And we read even worse things from the Talmud. Why do you think he treated her this way? It is offensive, but there's a strategy over there. What happened next is really, I want to tell you, extraordinary. And this is where we can understand the reason behind the story. See verse 27 and how the woman answered. And she said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table." In other words, what she's saying is that, Yeshua, if you say I'm a dog, so be it. But you are the Messiah and your words are the final authority. Greater faith, I want to tell you, is hard to find. And this is precisely what the disciples were lacking. This woman had greater faith than anyone down south in Jerusalem. And at this point, I want to tell you, Yeshua could not take it anymore. The lesson was given. And so he says in verse 28, this is beautiful. He says, "Oh woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire." And her daughter was healed from that very hour. Oh woman, that is a personal expression, an exclamation, one of admiration, really, because yes, Yeshua was impressed by her great level of belief and humility. And so we ask, why did he pronounce these harsh words to her? Why did he not come to her rescue when the disciple wanted to put her out? The whole thing not only brought out the faith of this woman, but the lack of faith on the part of the disciples, and the lack of also of knowledge at this point. They had to understand that they had to go to the Gentiles. And of course, you cannot go and preach the word to anyone unless you have a love for these people. And during this conversation, it must have been hard for Yeshua. Hard. Perhaps he tried to lessen the impact on the woman by using the Greek word for dog, a puppy. Puppy, and not the point to emphasize, let's say, a dog like one of a scavenger dog that they had at the time. So the Greek word for puppy used in conversation with this woman is only found here in this passage. A puppy is better, of course, than a wild dog. And have you seen how cleverly this story was designed? At the end, everyone is a winner. Her faith was declared. Her daughter was cured. And the disciple heard their lesson. This Canaanite woman is one of the same kind as Rahab, as Tamar, and also as Ruth, with whom we have begun to see a great love story, which typifies our relationship with our Savior, the Messiah.